Today we are going to do a comparison review of not 7, not 8, but a total of 4 neckband earphones. And all of these cost around 2000 rupees. Two of these models have just been released, and we have the Samsung's Level U2 and Boat Rocker's 255 Plus Pro with us, and we also have two slightly older competitors with the Oppo Enco M31 and the OnePlus Bullet Z. So let's check out which one is the best for you. Hey guys, I am Siddharth, and let's get started. So the design of Boat Rocker's Oppo M31 and OnePlus Bullets is quite similar. All of these have a flexible neckband through which the wires come out. The Oppo M31 are the lightest at 22 grams and the other two are slightly heavier at 26 and 28 grams. All of these are quite wearable on your neck, but still the Oppo Enco feel the least present. The Samsung Level U2 has a very different approach here, as it features a hard plastic neckband that weighs 42 grams, which is significantly heavier than the other two. Its design is also quite different, as its neckband is shaped to wrap around your body and it works quite well. The earphone wires come out of the back of the neckband, which is actually a better design, so even though they are heavier, you don't really feel that on your neck. One disadvantage of this design is that because the neckband isn't flexible, you are not going to be able to carry them around as easily as other earphones. All of these earphones have magnetically attaching earbuds, which is a really nice feature to have, but the Oppo and OnePlus earphones work a little differently, as both of them don't have a power button, so they power on when you detach their earbuds from each other, and they power off when you put them back in their attached position. The Samsung and Boat earphones have traditional power buttons, and both of these approaches have their pros and cons, as you don't have to press any buttons when using OnePlus and Oppo earphones, but they do disconnect from your phone when you put them in a resting position on your chest. The controls on these earphones are also quite similar, as with the Samsung and Oppo earphones, you get the control on the neckband, while the OnePlus and Boat have their controls on the earphone wire. And all of these earphones allow you to change volume, play and pause your track, and skip to the next or previous tracks. On Samsung earphone, I wasn't able to figure out a way to launch Google Assistant or Siri, but all the other earphones allow you to do that. The controls on Oppo M31 are easiest to use. The Samsung U2 are also easy to operate, but it's not easy to get a feel for their buttons as they are integrated into the neckband material. The Boat and OnePlus earphones have their controls in their wires, which I don't like because you have to find where the control unit is on the wire. It's not a big deal, but it is less convenient than other systems. Coming to their comfort, I would say that all of these can be worn for long periods, but there are some differences between them. So the Oppo Enco M31 have a weird oval shape on their earbuds, so even though they are comfortable to wear, it's not the most ear-friendly shape. The OnePlus Bullets do have that more ear-friendly shape, so I like their feel better, but the Boat earphones have very small earbuds and they also have ear hooks in their design which work well. So between these three in-ear style earphones, I would say that they have an edge in the comfort department, even though the other two are also good. The Samsung Level U2 have a hybrid earbud and in-ear monitor like design, so they sit inside your ear instead of going deep into your ear canal, so they feel very different. If you don't like how the other earphones feel, these are quite good, and their neckband design keeps the earbuds feeling very light, so they are very comfortable. But over time, you do feel their presence in your ear, so they do tire your outer ear after some time. So the comfort level is as good as other earphones, but you may like these better if you prefer the earbud style. Coming to the quality of their mics, the OnePlus Bullets clearly has the best microphone, the Boat Rocker's is probably the second best, and Oppo and Samsung are quite similar on third place. Now I'll have mic tests, and you should listen to the quality of the voice instead of what I'm saying, because I didn't know how good these mics were until I recorded them and compared. This is how the microphone sounds. It's very close to your mouth. I think that it sounds really great, and the people I called with these said that my voice was very clear. And this is how the microphone sounds on the OnePlus Bullet Z, and I'm kind of surprised by how good it sounds, like all the depth of my voice is in here, and I thought that it was going to sound almost the same as the Oppo Enco M31, but it does sound way better. Now we are testing the microphone on the Boat Rocker's 255 Plus Pro, and it actually sounds better than what I was expecting. We still don't have as clear of a voice as the OnePlus Bullet's Wireless Z, but it is still usable. Now we are finally testing the mic on the Samsung Level U2, and it is similar in quality to the Boat and Oppo microphone. Very usable for calls, but it is not as good as OnePlus microphone. Do give this video a thumbs up if you are liking it so far, and you can also subscribe to the channel with bell so you don't miss out on future videos. For wireless connectivity, all of these have Bluetooth 5.0, which is great. The product page for the Boat Rockers says that they support aptX codec, but I didn't see that working on my phone, so I am not sure about their claim. The Samsung Level U2 support AAC HD audio, which is nice. I also didn't see any special HD codec on the OnePlus Bullet Z, but the Oppo Enco M31 support LDAC, which is probably the best HD audio codec. This is really amazing to have in this price range, but all of these codecs don't make as much of a difference as people think on these entry-level earphones, because their drivers are just very entry-level in their quality, so a better codec doesn't make them significantly better. These are all Bluetooth earphones, so none of them is going to provide a low enough latency for gaming, and even OnePlus's low latency mode that works only with OnePlus phones doesn't get it low enough. The battery life on these earphones varies a lot, so the Oppo Enco M31 offer the lowest duration at around 12 hours or even less if you use them in their LDAC codec. The Samsung and OnePlus earphones offer significantly more battery life at 18 and 20 hours, but the Boat Rockers really live up to their 255 Plus Pro Max Ultimate Titanium naming scheme, and they deliver a stunning 40 hours of battery life. And I was quite skeptical about this promise, so I played Pink Noise on these for around 38 hours, and the battery level still showed up to be 40% on my iPad, so these will definitely deliver the promised duration, and I think all of these earphones except Samsung also offer quick charge, which is also a nice bonus. It is also really great to have Type-C charging ports on all of these earphones. The Samsung earphones don't have any water or dust resistance rating that they have mentioned on their website, but all of the other three earphones have that, with the Oppo having IPX5 water resistance rating, the OnePlus adding some dust resistance with IP55, and the Boat Rockers having a higher IPX7 rating, which means that you should be able to immerse them in water unlike other earphones. I think that all of these earphones should survive splashes of water, but just be careful if you're in the rain if you go for Samsung. Finally, coming to their sound quality, I have made a detailed video on Oppo versus OnePlus comparison, which you can watch by clicking on this card, but the summary of that was that the Oppo Enco M31 have a more balanced sound, and I didn't like the V-shaped sound signature of the OnePlus Bullet Z. And now they have a bass edition, which I think has even more bass, so that is really not what I think results in good quality audio, because you want to have a balance between different parts of music so you can hear them all. It is a similar case with the Boat Rockers 255 Plus Pro, as they also have a prominently V-shaped sound signature, and even though the bass on them is good considering all the features they are offering, the mids feel more recessed, and I don't like the treble spike they have, so they don't sound that good to me. The OnePlus Bullet Z execute that V-shaped sound in a better way than the Boat Rockers, so they will be a better option if you don't want to buy Oppo Enco M31. Now, when we compare the Samsung Level U2 and Oppo M31 to each other, it becomes quite complex because both of these earphones have a very different way of being in your ears. So the Oppo M31 offers a more typical in-ear monitor-like sound. It is quite balanced, but their sound stage is towards the narrower side. I still like their sound a lot, and I think that they offer better sound quality than the OnePlus and Boat earphones. But the Samsung Level U2 have a very open sounding presentation in their sound, and their hybrid earphone design works quite well, so they sound more natural, and the vocals on them also sound really great. The instruments have better separation between them than the other IEM earphones, and the treble also sounds very non-fatiguing and natural, and they also have a much better sound stage. But because they don't seal your ears like the Oppo earphones, they don't have a noise isolation that is nearly as good as other earphones. But more importantly, they don't deliver the bass in the same way as other earphones. So if you are listening to electronic music, you are really not going to hear deep bass, and even in other mainstream tracks that depend on bass, you are not going to get that satisfying thumping bass. So while these are really great for tracks that focus mainly on vocals and for other genres like classical music, they are not an all-rounder pair of earphones, so overall, I would say that it is a tie between Oppo and Samsung here. For sound quality alone, I would recommend Oppo Enco M31 to most people, but if you can sacrifice the need for IEM level bass, the Samsung Level U2 are definitely going to sound better for music that doesn't depend on bass kicks to sound good. For watching movies, TV shows, and videos on YouTube like this one, they might also sound better as voices on them sound really good. So in conclusion, this was quite a complex video to make because we don't have any one product that beats other products in all categories. The Oppo Enco M31 sounds the best for most genres of music, but it also has a significantly lower battery life than other earphones. The Samsung Level U2 sounds the best for many genres of music that aren't focused on bass, and it has an amazing open-sounding presentation. The battery life is great at 18 hours, so it can also be a really great choice. The OnePlus Bullets Wireless Z has the best microphone, and it can be the best for calling, and its battery life is also very good at 20 hours. The Boat Rocker's 255 Plus Pro Max Ultimate Titanium definitely has the best battery life here, and it also offers very good comfort. But the sound quality is comparatively not as good, even though it is not that far behind OnePlus Bullet Z. If I personally had to choose one, I would go either with the Oppo Enco M31 because I don't need a big battery, or I would go with the Samsung Level U2 because it is really great for watching TV shows in addition to sounding really great. A friend of mine who needs an earphone for calling is very happy with the OnePlus Bullet Z, and the Boat Rockers can be a considerable option if you have a use case for a 40-hour battery life. Even though the earbuds of Boat Rockers are made of metal, they do have an overall lack of quality and finishing touches that the other earphones from bigger brands have. But I will say that they are not bad, and I don't think that people going for them will be unhappy. And that was it for this video. I'll have links to buy all of these earphones in the video description. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell, follow me on socials, check out my Amazon store. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.